All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for accessing this video. This video is all about what are the signs of divorce in Vedic astrology. So there are certain combinations, there are certain placements of the planets which denotes divorce in your life or multiple marriages. All right. So most importantly, the placement of Jupiter, Venus and Mars plays a major role, and also Moon. Jupiter, Venus, Mars and Moon plays a major role in determining the marriage in the people's life. And most importantly, 7th house talks about marriage and 5th house talks about love and romance and relationships. And most importantly, the 7th house has to be analyzed in a deeper perspective. Let's say if at all you have in the 7th house, if at all any planet is debilitated, it can be any planet, it can be Mars, Sun, Moon, Jupiter, Venus, Saturn, Rahu or Ketu staying in the 7th house and they are debilitated, then there is a chance that you will undergo divorce and then you'll be married to another person. All right. And let's say 7th Lord is sitting in the 12th house. Okay. Or 12th Lord sitting in the 7th house. There is also indication that there might be a separation with your spouse after the marriage, if at all you have this combination. And let's say Venus is debilitated. Let's say Venus is in Virgo sign in the male's birth chart. Then there may be a relationship breaks in your life. Okay. And let's say Jupiter is debilitated in the female's birth chart. Then there is an indication that you might undergo separation with your spouse. So for that, you people has to do the remedy for Venus and Jupiter. So you got to examine your birth chart and you have to take that precautionary measures and also the recommendations from the astrologer. And most importantly, you have to perform the remedy to planet Venus and Jupiter. Okay, because Jupiter represents husband in the female's birth chart, whereas Venus represents wife in the male's birth chart. Okay, so the placement of Venus and Jupiter plays a major role. And this, and let's say if Jupiter is Jupiter or Venus is hemmed between Rahu and Ketu, then there may be a separation between your wife. Okay, and let's say if at all you have malefics in 4th house, 8th house and 12th house, and Venus state is sitting in a very bad sign afflicted with Rahu and Ketu, then there is a sign that we'll be getting a divorce. Okay. And let's say according to Parashara, as I mentioned to you, any malefics like Saturn, Rahu, Ketu are afflicting Venus in their 7th house, 5th house, 9th house and also 1st house. This represents divorce in your birth chart. And let's say Venus in Aries, Gemini, Cancer, Scorpio, it is not considered as good for happy married life. The reason being, Venus becomes enemy for these zodiac signs. Aries, Gemini, Cancer and Scorpio. Venus should not be staying here. In Aries and Scorpio, the signs of Mars causes immoral life and loss of reputation. Okay. In Cancer, it makes the wife overindulgent and passionate. The wife will be expecting so many things from you. In Gemini, especially Navamsha, Venus should not be afflicted, guys. Venus should be free from the malefics Rahu and Ketu. If at all Venus is hemmed between Rahu and Ketu, there may be a separation that might also turn into divorce. Okay. And the placement of Mars is also plays a major role. If at all you have Venus, Mars and Rahu in a combination in the 8th house, so that also represents divorce. Okay. Venus and Moon conjunction also represents unhappy married life. Okay. Venus is the karaka for love and sexual affairs, and Moon is the karaka for mind. So both should not be afflicted by Saturn and Mars. Okay. This is the principles of Sage Parashara Hora Shastra. Okay. And let me talk about placement of Mars. Mars also plays a major role in terms of determining the marital life or also divorce. If at all Mars is placed in the 1st house, 4th house, 7th house, 8th house and 11th and 12th houses, this is considered as Mangalik Dosh. You are supposed to marry to a people who are Mangalik in nature, so that energy of Mars is balanced there. Okay. So if at all Mars is afflicted in your birth chart, especially in the female birth chart, it is not good. There may be a separation, there will be obstacles in terms of getting married, marriage. And most importantly, if Mars is afflicted, it might even turns up into love marriage. And Mars should be free from Rahu and Ketu as well in your birth chart to have a happy married life. All right. So these are certain combinations of according to Sage Parashara Hora Shastra and also Saravali. Okay. Saravali and Parashara Hora Shastra, the two Vedic texts that we refer for Vedic astrology predictions. All right. So thank you so much for watching this video. And if at all you need my consultations, please book from the link that is mentioned in the description section. Once I get an order, I'll be able to help you with a complete analysis related to your birth chart. Okay. And also, if at all you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe to my YouTube channel and also click on the bell icon next to subscribe button. And also, let me know what exactly you have learned from this video. What are the principles you have learned from this video? Please mention in the comment section so that other people also will get benefited by watching your comments. Okay. Happy and have a nice day. Bye for now.